And welcome to Healing Moon Tarot. This is your weekly reading for, where am I at? Oh, Virgo. Hi, everybody. Virgos, let's see what's happening with you. Just going to shuffle these cards up with your energy. Virgo, what does Virgo need to know? Okay, let's see what the overall energy is for Virgos. What does Virgo need to know? What does Virgo need to know? What does Virgo need to know? Virgo, too many cards. Virgo, there we go. Thank you. Ooh, I see a creative endeavor. Now, this is often cooperating, compromising. There's some kind of event. I see abundance starting to flow. Now, I do see the loving man. Oh, you're feeling the love, or you're loving something you do. Yeah, I do see an energy of deserving, being conscious, being deserving. It's about, you know, knowing you deserve love. And that's what I feel like it's trying to say. But I see a lot of optimism. It's an energy of trying to be optimistic, being open to love. Maybe you're getting yourself out there again, but it's being conscious of deserving love. Okay. Yeah. Wow. Know your worth, Virgo. Now let's have a look at the energy here with this event. What is this event all about, or events? This could be some sort of invitation or opportunity. Okay, maybe a creative endeavor. It could be teaming up, collaborating. Yeah, so we have someone here reaching out. So someone here is a little unsure if someone's going to reciprocate. It has to do with generosity. Okay, yeah. So I think someone's going to reach out. It has to do with being generous. Yeah, something here is written in stone. There's already something planned. It's an 11. So I feel two people coming together. Yeah, I do see the scales of justice on the stone. It has to do with some sort of commitment. Okay, so this is an actual commitment. So you see the 11, two people coming together here. Yeah, I think someone here, it has to do with someone reaching out, hoping the other person reciprocates, but I see something very generous here. Very nice. Yeah, I see the 10 of Pentacles, safety, security, and stability, partnering up. Now, this could be an event, some sort of gathering, but it's also an energy of feeling like home. Okay, so it does look like two people possibly partnering up. Now, it could be on a creative endeavor, but someone here's got love on their mind. Yeah, very nice. Look at that. So we have the Oak King. Someone's taking a little pause. They're looking at things from a different perspective, often putting the shoe on the other foot, how the other person feels. But I do feel it could be someone who's been checking you out, maybe at a place where you were at some kind of event, musical event, artistic event, photography. I see literature. I also see a beach. Yeah, very nice. So there's something here. There's some sort of commitment, the standing stone. This is already something that's been committed to, or someone's thinking about that. Yeah, they're definitely been doing some, you know, kind of soul searching, going within, a little introspection. Ooh. Virgo, what's going on? Yeah. So I do see the High Priestess, a little Pisces energy. There's a lot of Pisces here. So this is somebody here trusting their intuition, their inner knowing. So I feel this person already knows the answers they're seeking. It has to do with partnering up. It also has to do often with a place where people socialize. It's a safe place, so it's about feeling safe. Now, what I like about the High Priestess is someone here is kind of going within. You can see, into me I see. So make sure you know you are, be conscious you deserve love, okay? Now, if somebody wasn't very generous or weren't reciprocating, or you feel they took advantage, okay? So be conscious of that, yeah. Like I say, this has to be something to do with this sort of a commitment. And I see the scales of justice. So it's about being fair. Maybe somebody wasn't being fair. They may be putting the shoe on the other foot, looking at how they feel. Yeah. Interesting. Yeah, we have the high priest and the high priestess. Ooh, that's interesting. I haven't seen these two together for a while. So I feel it's an energy of manifesting communication. Someone here has everything they need to manifest their desire. See, someone here has everything but love. And I do feel it's an energy of being open. Now, if this is coming towards you, it's saying to be optimistic. It's an energy of being optimistic towards a new beginning. Okay, it's an energy of someone being open. What you put out there, see, someone was very generous. What you put out there, you're about to receive. So you're about to receive something here. Make sure you know, okay, that be conscious of deserving. But like I say, it's also an energy of someone who often feels a little entitled to get more than they give. But I do feel this is a past energy. So I think someone here is about ready to be a little more generous with their love, their time. They want to partner up here. So this is really nice, Virgo. Yeah, a little Gemini energy. So this is often your energy, Mercury energy. So it's an energy of manifesting this. Okay, and if there's going to be some kind of communication, it's saying to trust your intuition. You already know. You likely know who this is. Okay, but this person also, I feel, has gone within. They've gone within. They're looking at this from a different perspective, putting the shoe on the other foot. Just a change of perspective. So it looks very positive, very optimistic. So let's have a look at the Six of Pentacles. Why is this here for Virgo? Six of Pentacles. Yeah, so somebody was definitely in a very negative space. That's an energy of lack, loneliness. Yeah, so somebody here, I don't know, maybe they didn't have a lot of money, you know, but it's often just someone who has a lot of negative thinking, a self-fulfilling prophecy. So someone's been looking at that and they're putting the shoe on the other foot. So I feel it's just a change of perspective. Someone who was feeling, that it was negative, it's not good enough, whatever the issue, okay, they now have a change of perspective. And possibly a change of heart. Let's have a look at the standing stone. Why is this here? Yeah, so it's an energy of happiness. So someone here is definitely a change of perspective. They're feeling happier. This is an energy of some sort of event or gathering of some sort, but it's very positive. It's a very happy home, happy life kind of energy. Someone's about to put themselves out there. It's often someone wearing their heart on their sleeve. Putting all the cups on the table. Let's have a look at the creative endeavor. Yeah, so something ended. There's a painful period in someone's life that's over. Okay, it's over, it's done. Now, the event, it is an eight, it has to do with abundance. So something here wasn't successful because someone wasn't giving or sharing of themselves, or they weren't being generous. Maybe they feel they took advantage. It's hard to say what happened, but there's just a lot of lack. But I feel that's all different now because it's over. Something is over. It's finished. Beautiful. Yeah. So I do see balance. See, being fair. It has to do with doing something right, maybe making something right. It's about being fair, looking at a situation that maybe wasn't fair. So, yeah. Yeah, there was a little confusion. Someone here is kind of gone within, into me, I see, looking at all their feelings. Now, it could be a fear of commitment, could be a fear of emotional intimacy, all kinds of things. But it's about bringing back the balance. Somebody here maybe wants to make things right, or like I say, they're doing that inner work, facing the fear of commitment. Yeah, let's have another look at the moon. Why is the moon here? And it's also sometimes confusion, you know, someone feeling a little confused. Maybe having to face that fear, little inner work. Yeah, see, that's over. Something ended. And that could be someone who ended a painful relationship. Okay, they maybe were going through something. Now this person's definitely feeling better. Different perspective. So this is often internal, where somebody just feels kind of dead inside the end of a relationship. But this is where it all changes. See, change of perspective. So someone's gone through a bit of an awakening. So whatever is over, it's over. Someone having to face that fear, something is done. There was lack. But I feel this is someone feeling much better. Beautiful, yeah. It's an energy of investing. See, someone's no longer invested in this. It's also someone being more patient. It's looking at what they're investing in. So I feel someone's ready to invest in love. I do feel patience is required here, but I also see an energy of balance, doing something just right. I feel somebody just didn't come in right too. They had maybe just started something and then, you know, before something was over, before they were over it. So this person's looking at this, but I feel for yourself, you're going to look at this if you are the feminine. Yeah. See, it has to do with a passion, new beginning, a spark. So there's a spark here. There's some kind of the fire's lit. So this is someone looking at that. They're ready for a passionate new beginning. It has to do with making a choice, choosing the one. Yeah. Whatever happened, I feel it was painful. Someone may have stabbed someone in the back, literally here. But you can see here, it's the end of this fear, the end of a relationship. Someone maybe didn't want to face that it was over, but I feel like it is. And I feel they're good. Okay. Let's have a look at the High Priestess. Yeah, you can see into me, I see. Someone was focused on the cups that were spilled. A lot of negative energy, the cup half full. See, this is somebody who wasn't over something. So it's like they started something and they weren't focused on the Two of Cups. They weren't focused on the what was in front of them. They were still focused on this negative energy. So I do feel this is somebody here ready to manifest. They have everything they need to manifest love. So there's going to be some kind of communication. Yeah, someone's been working a lot. They have everything they need. They're perfecting their craft and skills. So it's an energy of someone putting in more effort. So they've definitely done some inner work. Often while focusing on work, it's an energy of someone who's independent. They take care of themselves. But again, it's that be conscious of deserving. Okay? Know your worth. Yeah, it's an energy of knowing you deserve better. Yeah, beautiful energy. So I do feel this person's looking at this, but I do feel with this energy, something wasn't successful. So they've been focused on money. They're definitely successful. I see some kind of victory. So someone who's broke free from this. Yeah, really nice. It's that energy of freedom, but often when you feel the most free is when you're in love. So I do feel we have someone here who's, you know, planning and preparing for success. They're hoping for the best. I feel at some point here, they kind of feel like, you know, you might not reciprocate. You may not feel the same. Okay. This is where the energy is. So, but I feel this is someone planning, preparing for success. And I do see a possible victory. I see a lot of the start of something new, feeling very optimistic. Yeah, there's a situation coming to fruition. It hasn't completely played out yet. There's still one more cup. See, this is energy of someone kind of playing it safe. See, so that's why I say, this is make sure that it isn't somebody just coming in for attention where they want you to fill their cup because they didn't get what they wanted before. So you want to just watch for that, okay? It's about looking out for yourself, looking out for number one, making sure this person isn't just coming for attention, okay? But I do feel someone's planning for success, hoping for the best. It is about putting in the effort. So this is someone who's pretty determined here. Like I say, it's an energy of being optimistic, but playing it safe. 1 minute they feel very optimistic, the next minute they're not sure they're going to get what they want here. But it's also telling you, if this is somebody here who came in with negative energy, if they don't come in right and they just come in looking for attention or sympathy, okay, you want to watch that. Don't indulge, okay? Don't indulge in that, okay? Because it's an energy of you deserve better. But I think this person wants to communicate this. Yeah, you deserve better. Let's have a look at the Nine of Cups. Why is this here? Yeah, so there's some indecision. You might be unsure. But I also feel this person fails to see. This is someone who is indecisive. They fail to see. Yeah, see, it's an energy of indulging, filling someone's cup, but not giving them what they want. So I do feel you're going to have to make a decision, but I feel a lot of this is their own indecision. See, looking at things from a different perspective, back and forth in their head. They may not get what they want. So I do feel it's an energy of playing it a little safe for yourself, because I feel they will too. Yeah, see, what this is cooperation, compromise, compatibility, the things you have in common. You both might be a little indecisive. You might be playing it safe. Okay, because you're looking out for your own best interest. You want to make sure this person's intentions are honorable, because this is about whether they're honorable or not. So cooperation, compromise, compatibility, going down this path, teaming up. So it's an energy of just acknowledging. Okay, there's some things that need to be acknowledged before you can move forward. And that's what I feel, acknowledging that you deserve better. Okay, it's also someone who deserves to be able to focus on work. They deserve to be successful. But if someone comes in and they feel entitled, that you're supposed to give them attention and fill their cup, you might not be so sure. So there's things that need to be acknowledged before any decision could be made. And it has to do with, see, someone pulling back. It's about calming down, trying something different. Now, if you feel something is off, make sure you acknowledge it with this person. Okay, it needs to be acknowledged if it feels off. But it's an energy of whether something is right or not. So, like I say, you might not see this coming. It might make you indecisive, okay? But what I also see is this person. I feel this person's a little afraid to face the fear that you may not reciprocate, you may not be interested, okay? Because something's happened. But like I say, it's an energy of looking at this differently. Just, I see calm, I see peace. And being patient. So there's things that need to be acknowledged before any decision can be made. And don't be afraid to do that. It's about trying something different, doing things differently. Okay, so I do see optimism. I feel there's a reason for to be optimistic, but I feel this person's a little careful what they wish for. Okay, because I do feel it has to do with having to face, I feel, the fact that you might not feel the same. Okay. It's hard to say. I feel it's a little up in the air, and I do see somebody's pride and ego, so that has a lot to do with it too. See, releasing the pride and ego. So someone's had a death of the ego. It's an energy of leaving the ego out of it. So it has to do with someone coming in being humble. So like I say, a little, I feel there's a need for a little caution, but I do feel there's a situation about to come to fruition. But it's just saying to just be patient and kind of, it's about listening. Okay, listening to each other, okay, before you make a decision, acknowledging. I feel we have two people who are very much the same, yet different. But often this is an energy of two people who are just right for each other because you balance each other out. One person's a little different, okay, and this is also acknowledging your skills, what you both bring to the table. See, these are people with two different skills, two different mindsets, two different ways of living their life. The way they talk, the way they communicate, all these things. But you're very much the same, but yet you're different. So it has to do with balance. The Three of Pentacles is about balance. It's what two people bring to the table, your skills, because it's about building more. It's about teaming up and going down this path. So it's an energy of someone wanting to try something different. Okay. So I feel this could be something worth exploring. But if you start to feel something is off, where they're just coming in looking for attention and you find they're not putting in the effort and there's lack, like I say, you might decide to just break free from this and move on. It's all up to you. But I do feel this is actually very positive. Okay. There's definitely been the death of the ego here. Okay. Someone's pride may have gotten in the way. So it could be somebody here having to, you know, maybe eat a little crow. It's hard to say. I don't know where that came from, but yeah, it's an energy of having to be humble. So take care. I wish you the very best, okay? Temper the passions, temper the emotions and the pride. Leave the pride out of it, okay? Try something different. The ego needs to go, okay? So I do feel this could be successful. Take care and we'll see you soon.